Well, we are now in Casa Albero in Fregene, one of the most interesting architectural examples in the Italy of the late 70s. I am Raynaldo Perugini. I introduce myself. I am an architect. I am one of the three architects of this house, because this house was our family toy, as I was saying yesterday with friends. Our family toys, because my father, Giuseppe Perugini, was a very famous architect. He had done great buildings like the Memorial of the Fosse Ardeatine or the building in Piazzale Clodio. He was a great architect. He was the leader of the family from an architectural point of view. And he was a professor of architecture. My mother, also architect, was a professor for the engineers in Rome, then in Florence, and then in Rome again. And I am a professor of history of architecture at the Third University of Rome. And so, all together, we had invented this building. This building comes from some experiences made by my father and my mother that won a prize, the first prize in Akfinsider for architectural experimental architecture. My father, in fact, was always trying to make a new experience in the field of architecture, even in international competition. For instance, one of the bridges of Messina with a round bridge. Now you can see at Maxi in Rome, or also the towers of Plateau Beaubourg. And the house was our way of demonstrating our architecture. How we did work? My father made a drawing of everything. You could not put a pencil on his work, but we were around him discussing. I usually say that my family was a democracy, where everybody could say what he wanted, and in the same way, there was not the leader. I am the architect, shut up, it's not our way. And so when we started doing this house, we had many ideas. The house has a very peculiar feature, that the walls are not necessary. You say, why the walls are not necessary? Because the structure is conceived in a certain way that you can even have a paper wall. Because all the things that are ruling the building are outside. And so we decided, after many discussions, after many drawings, to invent this peculiar solution. It's one of the many possibilities of doing this house. And also, if you have noticed, or if you notice, will notice when you come and see it, the corners are broken. Why the corners are broken? Broken or with glass, with window? Because in the ancient architecture, in the Renaissance architecture, that's my field, the corner were the stronger piece of the building. So here we do not have this problem, and so the corner are open. Another thing interesting, what we have done. My father had the ideas, my mother said what he was thinking about. I have designed a fence, for instance, it was something that I've done myself. And also another thing interesting is that my father worked every time. He was always working. In the morning when he arrived, he went on the table, drawing table, and started drawing. Then he went to the university when the days were the days of his lesson. Then he came back, he was eating a little thing, then a little snap, a little time to sleep, a little sleep, then again, working again, then for dinner, then again working. And we have no holidays. In fact, the idea of a holiday, for me, is still difficult to conceive. Because a holiday is something for people that don't like what they're doing, in fact. It's a moment free where they can do what they want. But if you do what you want, you have no problem. You can have holidays when you want. And so it's what we had. We had some holidays when we wanted. I've traveled all over Europe, even in Russia, in Russian lands. I've been in Ukraine. I've been everywhere seeing modern architecture, because my father used to teach architecture showing modern architecture, a kind of mix between history and drawing. And so the house in Fregene was very useful, because Fregene is only 30 minutes from Rome, usually, sometimes not, but usually half an hour. And so my father could work, could stay here. At the time, university stopped at the end of July and started again in November. So we had 3 months of holidays. 3 months of holidays, of working holidays, obviously, for my father. And so to have this house in Fregene was very useful, as I was saying, because my father could work, and if somebody wanted to talk to him, they could come, or he could go to Rome and see what happened. So he could continue to follow his work without problems. And another thing interesting is that have been written many silly things about the house. Really, because the house was so peculiar that when you are here, after 5 minutes, you have somebody that come and ask you to if you can come in and see and take a snapshot and so that, everything. So, but it's also very well renowned in the world. If you open Google, you can find many pages about Casa Albero, Casa Sperimentale, Casa di Giuseppe Perugini. So was immediately very important from the architectural point of view. I said that there were written many silly things. For instance, the ball, la palla, is another kind of building. The house, the Casa Albero, where we are now, is the endless house, because it can be continued as you want. You have another child, and you continue another piece of the house. But the ball is the house is not possible to continue. It's just complete, 5 meters diameter, and they had written the meditation room. They told also about the house brutalism. This house, I am sure that there's nothing to deal with brutalism. Perhaps, as I was saying with friends yesterday, it's more near to Russian constructivism, to the experimental architecture of Lisitsky, of Rachenko. Perhaps, because my father was writing about this, and so perhaps some of these ideas had been put in the house. Another thing interesting, my father was a very good historian. But he didn't write, in fact, about history of architecture, just about Adolf Loos. There's a beautiful book about Adolf Loos, but made in the fashion of an architect, not as an historian, as an architect could see the works of Adolf Loos. And so, why I'm telling this to you? For many ideas in the works of my father come from his perfect learning of the past, a new way of looking at the past. Just I say Miss van der Rohe in Berlin, you know, the gallery, the modern art gallery, it's a temple. It's a modern temple with the stairs, with the columns. The columns are iron columns, but the idea, the shape, is that of classical architecture. And so all the architects, my father was born in 1940, all the architects of the time, born before the 20s, had studied in an ancient fashion. My father, I have some drawings of the Campidoglio di Michelangelo, of the columns, of the details of the Campidoglio by my father, that are at the size of the real size. And I have a lot of this. And for the house, there is still something to tell you. The drawing of the house, like it is, has been made after. You say, what does it mean, after? After, it means that, as I told you before, the walls are not necessary in this house. Yes, they are necessary to close the house, but they are not necessary from a certain point of view. So we invented to have some pieces that are drawers, that are for all the furniture, all the big furniture that usually is a stalling space in the house. No? This house is 110 square meters, and it looks enormous, because now we have no furniture, but all the big furniture is inside of the wall. And we made this, making these pieces like a model for children, I would say the toy house. And we have made these panels, special panels with something inside, and then we had put in their place where they are now. Then they are linked, and then we had the house. And in this way, the final drawings come after. We have a lot of ideas. The house had to be completely closed. Completely closed, with only some little glass signs that are on the floor and on the walls and on the top. And it was completely closed. When my father proposed this idea, my mother says, "You are crazy." But as I was saying before, we were architects. So everybody said, "No, you are crazy, but we can do something else." It was not just a simple way of saying, "No, I don't like all your idea." And so all of this was made in this house where we have lived. Somebody said, "But you have lived there." Yes, we have been there for many summer time. I lived there with my girlfriend some years ago. and so now it has been destroyed because in the papers they've written the house is an abandoned house. You can go there and do what you want, in fact. But now I'm trying to do something for a revival of this house. I want to transform this house for events, in fact. But events, it doesn't mean that I will not live there. It was a house open to the people. Now it's yet open, because everybody comes in as they want. So it's yet open, but I want to make this from a cultural point of view. I said not only cultural point of view, mainly cultural point of view. But if somebody would spend some night or week in the house, like it happens with other house of architects in the world, house of the Link iconic houses, for instance, perhaps it could be. That will be something that I hope we will see. I am trying. I've written a little book with my father. In fact, it's a little book about the house that had been made by my father with his own hands. And I printed it recently just to make to show that the house is alive, that we are there. I am still there. So I am here and I love this house, because it's a house that we have made we three. We were very, very close, especially with my father. We were very, very close. I like my father very much. Yesterday I was saying, I don't understand people that say, I cannot have a dialogue with my father. My father was very, a very nice person, a really good architect. No, it's not me that I have to say this. It's other people that say. So I'm just an historian. And historians are there just to recall. But lucky, I'm not just an historian, because in many works of my father, in many competitions, in other works that I'm doing now, I'm trying to do now, I am here as an architect. So I hope that you have enjoyed this conversation.